Hello，大家好，这里是望川日曦。那今天呢，想来和大家聊一聊说口语的那些事儿。不知道大家有没有这样的感受？在中学阶段呢，我们所学的英语将更多的精力放在了听、读、写这三方面。在这样的环境下呢，我们的口语就会相对的弱一些。我本人也有这样的情况，相比起听、读、写，我的口语会更差一些，同时有时也会羞于去开口说英语。但其实呢，学好一门语言最重要的还是要去说，只有能够用这门语言去交流了，才是真正的学好这门语言了。那今天呢，我就要在 Cambly 上做一个挑战，我要去连线外教老师，然后向他安利哔哩哔哩，向他安利自己的视频频道，同时呢，也就是想和他交流一下兴趣爱好上的一些问题。除此之外，也会向他请教一些大家在英语口语中容易碰到的一些问题。那话不多说，我们马上开始今天的挑战吧。
Now, let's start the listening comprehension.
Hello.
Hello.
What is your name?
My name is Juliana.
Juliana?
Yeah.
Oh, nice to meet you, Juliana.
Nice to meet you.
My name is Laura.
Hello, Miss Laura.
Where are you calling from?
I come from Shanghai, China.
Ah, okay, nice.
I'm a video blogger.
You're a video blogger?
Yes.
Oh, interesting. That's fun. So do you do your video blogs on YouTube?
Not YouTube. I upload my videos on Bilibili. We use it in China.
Ah, okay, cool. And how long have you been doing that for?
For more than 3 years.
3 years, wow. Have you got a little link and I can check it out?
Yes, let me show you. So this is my channel.
Okay, cool. Bilibili?
Yes, Bilibili, we use it in China. It likes YouTube and many vloggers will upload their videos.
Oh, this is really nice. This looks lovely.So how often do you put up a new video?
Once a week. And Miss Laura, I want to ask you some questions about how to practice spoken English. First is that we are always afraid to speak English and we are afraid to make mistakes. Do you have some solution or advice?That we can practice English well.
Yes, so as a teacher as well myself, mistakes are the best way to learn because I always encourage people to make mistakes. Nobody cares if you're speaking to people, nobody cares at all if you make mistakes. People are more than happy to help and people would much prefer that you tried rather than not trying for being too scared of making a mistake.I think in my school, when I've taught younger students, I normally teach maths, but it goes the same. It's the same for whatever you're teaching. If you're told that mistakes are bad and, you know, people never try, they never try. And when you...make a mistake, you know then that, okay, that I shouldn't, or that was wrong, but now you learn from it and you do it again. You remember making that mistake and then you don't do it again. So this is why they're a good tool for learning. I think they're very important and they help you. So I would much rather people talk and make the mistakes as I do because I'm trying to learn Spanish. It's just more about making an effort and trying, I think. Mistakes are good.
Yeah.But sometimes I will be shy to speak English in class.
Sometimes you'd be shy to speak English in class. Yeah. Would I think that's an issue for a lot of people. And I suppose the best way to just do that is just little by little try and ease yourself into it. When I recently traveled through Latin America and I didn't know any Spanish before I went. I took some lessons whilst I was there, and I, you know, would be listening to local speakers. And it took me a long time to actually start trying to speak, because you just get really scared, don't you, at the start? You're like, oh, I can't speak. Nobody's going to understand me. But I just started, you know, just saying like, hello, or thank you, or something very small. And then I would build that up each day and maybe say a new word or a new phrase, or I would work myself up to a level where I was saying full sentences rather than, you know, just, if you can come out right away and just try that, that's amazing. But if you're too shy, then I would build it up little by little.
Yeah, I think so. Thank you for your...
Oh, okay. No worries. No worries. I hope you have a lovely day. Lovely evening.
The same to
you. And good luck with your video. Good luck.
Bye bye.
Bye bye.
那我刚刚就在 Cambly 上和老师连线，我们大概交流了20多分钟吧。刚开始会比较的紧张，但是老师他会一步步带着你去，说英语，然后会纠正你当中的一些错误。如果你有什么问题去问老师的话，他也是非常乐意解答你的。其实呢，如果想要练习口语，我们就要克服自己，勇敢的去说。同时呢，我们也要尽可能给自己塑造一个比较好的练习环境。那对于我们来说呢，可能把自己置身于一个全英文的环境练习口语是比较困难的，所以我们可以通过 Cambly 这个平台，可以跟着外教老师来练习口语。通过我自己的尝试呢，我觉得外教老师都会非常的乐于帮你去纠正你口语中的问题，也非常乐于告诉你一些他们的学习经验，帮助你去更好的练习口语。在 Cambly 呢，有非常非常多的外教老师可供我们选择，我们可以根据自己的实际情况、实际需求去筛选老师。不管呢，你是为了通过雅思考试，或者只是为了锻炼自己的口语，都可以在这个平台上进行学习。而且上课时间呢也很灵活，可以提前和老师预约上课时间，也可以直接在平台上选择目前空闲的老师进行学习。这一次呢， Cambly 给了我一个推荐码，我把它打在这个屏幕上面，大家可以注册之后去使用推荐码，有15分钟的一对一免费外教课时，这个在手机和电脑端都是可以操作的，大家可以借助这个机会呢，去尝试和外教老师进行口语的交流练习，迈出自己的第一步。当然，如果觉得合适，也是可以去购买课程的。那今天的视频就到这里结束啦。